I have here, so I'm going to make sure there's no question of what team I'm with today. You know, my late mother used to say, you're known by the company you keep. Look at the company we're keeping today. Unbelievable. Beginning with your president, my dear friend and one of the great labor leaders in this country, Hector Figueroa. 32 BJ, Vice President and State Director, my dear friend Kevin Brown is on. To all of the members in this extraordinary union, to the faith leaders who are with us today, thank you, God bless you. And to the elected officials, we got a freeholder, we got a couple of assemblymen, we got a councilman and more. And most importantly, we got one of the best mayors, not just in this state, but in these United States of America, Roz Baraka. I'll be brief. I want to talk to you about minimum wage. I was in the room, stood up, and spoke, not for the first time, by the way, but at least this time to a more welcoming Port Authority group of commissioners in April. They made the decision to move the minimum wage to $19 an hour. I have every reason to believe that they will abide by that decision. Some of their representatives are here today. They, I believe, are acting completely with honor, and we'll make sure that that's the case. And I believe that with all my heart. And we plead for the private sector to stand up and abide by that decision, because it is the right thing to do. This is a long struggle. Many of you have been in the struggle from the beginning, for now I think 7 years at least in some cases. But this is a battle, an important battle in a bigger war for minimum wage. And it's a war we're gonna not relent on. We cannot accept levels of wages as they are in this state and in this country as they stand today. Even if you've got two incomes and you've got a couple of dependents, you are likely living at or below the poverty line today. And even when you get to $19, and God willing, we'll get there sooner than later, you're not much above it. This is, as Hector said, it's about dignity. It's about a livable wage. It's about security. I myself make the mistake when I talk about a stronger and fairer New Jersey that implies those are two different things. The fact of the matter is, the best example we have before us is minimum wage, which is both a big step in the direction of fairness, but it contributes to economic strength. I don't have to tell you, I met several of your colleagues today, and I've met many of you over the past several years. One of you lives in East Orange, one of you in Irvington, one of you in Newark, the three conversations I had. You will take that money and put it right back into your families and your communities. So it's not just fair and right, it adds to the strength of our society and our economy. So this is a huge battle, and it's a huge battle in an even bigger war, and we will achieve our objectives together. We rise and fall as one, and today we're rising. I could not keep better company today. I'm incredibly honored to be here. Que Dios te bendiga. 32!